Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and today I have some forbidden romance recommendations for you. I love a good forbidden romance, and I have made quite a few of these videos. They will be linked down below if you have not checked them out yet. I have 10 recommendations for you today, and they vary in genre. We have contemporary romances, there's a few darkish ones, there's novellas, you have alien ones, and even a few historicals. So let's get started. I'm so excited to talk about these. Forbidden romances are like some of my favorite things ever to read. First, I have Neat by Candy Steiner. This is her second book in the Becker Brothers series. I've actually only read this book in the series, so I would say that it's a standalone, but you don't need to read book one to read this one. Mallory is from this very small town, and her family owns this, I believe, whiskey distillery business, and she has never wanted to work there. It's her family's legacy, however, she never really had any passion for it. When she graduates college with her art degree, she is in need of a job. She does not have any money, and she can't find anywhere to work. Her dad offers her a proposition and is like, okay, I will pay for this art studio in our small town only if you work in the whiskey distillery business. And so she does just that. And the man who is going to show her the ropes of the business is Logan Becker. She is very interested in him, or they are very interested in each other from the get-go. However, their romance is very forbidden because there is a family rivalry. The Scooters, I believe her last name is Scooter, the Scooters and the Beckers clash hardcore. And her dad would be furious if he knew that she was in a relationship with a Becker brother. He would be so furious that he would take away her art studio for sure. There's also another forbidden aspect in the fact that he's her boss in this situation. And so they're trying to keep the relationship a secret from other employees, other people, as well as specifically her father. But this was really cute and really sweet. Logan really goes into understanding and trying to love art for Mallory because he just knows that she is so passionate about it, and I swooned over that. Next is My Dad's Best Friend by Katie Robert. This is definitely a forbidden romance because it is a romance with the heroine's dad's best friend. So our heroine here, she has been given, I believe, the ropes of this architecture business her dad has been running for years, and she really wants to snag these certain clients, and she knows the perfect architect that can build their dream home. It just so happens to be her dad's best friend who she has been pining after for years, but she thinks that he would never notice her in that way. She decides to drive to his house to ask him for help because he's retired, and she's there to basically beg him to like, help, please, you're gonna be perfect for this job. But while she gets there, she gets stuck in a storm and she cannot leave the house. She stays there overnight and things happen between the two of them while she stays there. This is definitely hot and fun. Doesn't take itself too seriously, and I love those sometimes. You just need to read books like that sometimes. And this book is definitely forbidden, and there's a reason why the hero of this book has not revealed his feelings to the heroine. The Doctor by Nikki Sloan is one of the most forbidden romances I've ever read. I loved this one. Cassidy in here is about to start her sophomore year of college, and she's been dating her high school boyfriend for years. They started dating while she was in high school, and they're now in their sophomore year of college. And he is becoming kind of like a poopy boyfriend. Like, he's not great to her. He only wants one thing, if you know what I mean, and that's it. And she feels like she's not valued as a woman, as a girlfriend. Like, she is not interested in him anymore. And so she breaks up with him one day at his house, and who is there to comfort her? Her boyfriend's dad. His name is Greg, and he has been lusting over his son's girlfriend for quite a long time. And he is like so disappointed in himself that he's having these feelings, but he can't help it. He cannot help it. He is totally into Cassidy. And Cassidy has also been looking at Greg for quite a while, honestly. And so this is very forbidden about the two of them getting together. There's sneaking in the house scenes. There's sneaking around her ex-boyfriend scenes. Like, this is so forbidden. Another Katie Robert is Queen Takes Rose, which is the last book in the Wicked Villains series, which can be read as a standalone. The series are all like Disney fairy tale retellings. This is the romance between Malone and Aurora. So a Sleeping Beauty retelling. It's basically if Aurora Sleeping Beauty got with Maleficent. So Aurora has this deal that she's made with Malone. She has to stay with her for 2 weeks and has to do everything that Malone tells her to do. She's doing this willingly, by the way. Like, it's with a certain club that Aurora is a part of and that Malone attends. And Malone is just looking for a fun 2 weeks with Aurora. She has been kind of like lusting after her for a while, but Aurora has some ulterior motives for agreeing to do this. She really wants to get revenge on Malone for something that she did to her family. This is very forbidden in the aspect that they are family rivals. Her family hates Malone's family, specifically Malone. Malone has done some crappy things to Aurora's family, and Aurora is there to get revenge. But then she can't help but fall for this woman. This is also an age gap romance. I feel like just a great sapphic romance that you need to pick up if you have not yet. A novella that I'd love to mention is Bulky by Jessica Kane. This is a very short novella, and the romance is between Gunnar and Josie. So Josie has a best friend, a best guy friend, and they've only ever been friends. She's 18 years old, she's about to go off to college, and she feels like this is the perfect opportunity to tell her best friend's dad, Gunnar, that she is in love with him, basically. She is making it a goal in life to make Gunnar hers, and she's gonna do everything in her power to do that. And Gunnar has obviously been into her for quite a long time, but she's 18 and he is quite older than her. That is his son's best friend. He thinks like it could never happen, but man, does Josie put herself out there with him. This is just a short, fun read that is very forbidden, and you're gonna figure out if her best friend takes it well or not, for sure. Next, I have Ensnared by Tiffany Roberts. This is my alien romance recommendation for this video. This is about Catan and Ivy. Catan is this spider alien. He's huge and kind of looks like an arachnid, but he lives on this planet where everyone looks exactly like him, basically. They're all spiders creatures. He is also like a reclusive hero. He doesn't really live in the village on the planet. He has his own little nest in the jungle. He's exploring the jungle one day and he comes across this spaceship, and he goes inside and realizes there's like a bunch of beings like asleep, and he accidentally clicks a button and this woman falls out of this tube that she's been cryosleeped in. Her name is Ivy, and he thinks of her as a pet at first, like, oh, I have a pet, let's go take care of her, let's bring her back to my cave, I'll take care of her. And then he soon realizes, oh no, this is like a sentient person. This is a woman, like, she's not a pet. There's a language barrier between the two, so it takes a while for them to start communicating with each other. I love this one because in a lot of alien romances where there's a language barrier, they just end up getting like a language chip, you know? This one, they actually like learn each other's languages, and that's how they communicate. And I love that. That was so cool. The two of them are stuck in his nest together and they fall in love, and oh, this one is so good. I love it so much. I need to read the other books in this series. This is a trilogy about Catan and Ivy. I've only read book one in their story. This one is forbidden for multiple reasons. This is a different person species romance, and there are no other humans in this world, and so it's very forbidden for them to be together. And he knows that if any other spider creature, alien of Ricks, they're called Rixes, were to find Ivy, she would be killed. And so he's like, I have to keep her secret. I have to keep her in my cave. Like, she cannot come out, which is a conflict between the two of them because she does not want to be stuck in a cave for the rest of her life, obviously. And another forbidden aspect is the queen of the Vrixes has set her eyes on Catan to be her mate, and he is not for it. She is cruel and evil and mean, and he does not want to be with her. He has to definitely keep Ivy a secret, because if she were to find out about her, she would kill Ivy in an instant. And she maybe tries to in this book. I love this one so much. If you've not read this alien romance and you love alien romances, pick it up, okay? Don't let the spider part deter you. I am petrified of spiders. This book did not scare me. Did not give me the heebie-jeebies. I loved it. We're next getting into our historical recommendations. First is Nobody's Duke by Scarlett Scott. This is a second chance romance between Ara and Clayton. When they were younger, I want to say like teen age, they lived on a neighboring property. However, they are from rivaling families. So they would sneak during the middle of the night in secret ways to get together and be together. There's one point where they're so much in love that they're gonna run away and get married. However, things happen, and the two of them think that the other person betrayed them on the night they were going to run away together. And ever since then, they have hated each other. But there is a misunderstanding that happens that is very, very interesting. It's years later. Our heroine is now a widow. She got married, she has a son, and the people who murdered her husband are now out to murder her. And there is the Secret League of Dukes, the League of Dukes. And they are kind of like spies. They work with the police a little bit to take down some bad people. and they have decided to task Clay to protect Aura because her husband was in the League of Dukes. And so he's basically gonna be her bodyguard for this time, and they're forced to be in forced proximity together. And the truth finally gets revealed about what happened that night all those years ago. I really love the second chance romance. It is so good. This is forbidden, at least in the beginning, because it's rivaling families. Their families would never approve. They were literally gonna run away and get married. And in the present time, the future chapters where they're all grown up now, it's less of a forbidden romance because they are now adults and can live their own lives. So, but the beginning part, definitely forbidden. I next have How to Pursue a Princess by Karen Hawkins. I love this series so much. Each book in this series is about one of the Balfour sisters getting matched by their godmother because they all need to get married. And so Lillian here goes to a house party that her godmother, who's a duchess, is putting together. And the goal of going to this house party is to get married. Her dad is in financial ruin, her family is, so she needs to marry wealthy. She knows that. She's like, it doesn't really matter if I love him or not. I just gotta find a rich man because my family is going destitute. And so Prince Volvinsky in this book is the hero. His name is Wolf. Sorry. He's a Prussian prince, and all he wants is for a woman to love him for who he is, not his title or his wealth. And he goes to this house party, he's been invited to it, and there he meets Lily, and from the moment he sees her, he knows that this woman is his. Lily is totally into him as well and is falling in love with Wolf, but she is having a really hard time because she knows that if she does not marry a rich man, like, her family will be ruined. Like, she wants a better life for her family. Up front, when he meets people, Wolf says that he's a prince, but he's like a destitute prince. He doesn't have any money, which is a total lie because he wants a woman to fall in love with him for who he is, not his money. And so the two of them are falling in love, but Lily keeps saying, no, like, I can't be with you. I can't say yes to marrying you because I need to marry for money. And so Wolf is just waiting for her to accept him for him and not the money. I love this one so much. It is such a fun read. Every book in this series is hilarious as well. The Duchess in here, her godmother, is so funny, does a lot of hijinks and scheming, and she has a bunch of pugs that do some scheming. It is so stinking cute. Seduction of a Highland Lass by Maya Banks is also definitely forbidden. Each book in this series is about a McCabe brother. This is the second book in the McCabe trilogy. It's about a McCabe brother falling in love. In the first book in the series, the hero fell in love with a woman, and the woman he was going to marry, like in an arranged marriage, like betrothed to, kind of like gets pushed to the side, and that alliance can't happen. And so Alaric decides to marry that woman instead, so their families can't be aligned. So on his way to travel to her land, her family land, he gets ambushed and attacked, and he's basically on his last leg of life. Like, he's dying while laying on this horse. And the horse ends up stopping in front of this cabin in the middle of nowhere. This is Keely's cabin. Keely is a very talented healer, and she ends up nursing Alaric back to health. And while he's being healed, he thinks that an angel is taking care of him and saving his life. And when he wakes up, he realizes, no, it's been Keely this whole time, and he's falling in love with Keely. They spend time in this cabin together in their own little bubble in their world, and they don't think about the outside world. They fall in love. But then he realizes, I'm still betrothed to this woman. I have to marry her to make an alliance with our families. Like, what am I gonna do? This is very forbidden because he has another woman he has to marry. He's never met her. He knows nothing about her, but he's totally in love with Keely. And so this is a giant forbidden aspect in here. this whole series is so much fun to read. I loved this one. And lastly, I have A Wallflower Christmas by Lisa Kleypas. This is a book, though, you need to read after reading the Wallflower series. I don't recommend reading this one as a standalone because you get to see all the previous couples pop up in this book, as well as a new romance. So this is forbidden in the aspect of the new romance plotline in here, but you definitely get the older couples from the series pop up in here as well. Rafe in here is visiting the Wallflower friends. I don't remember how they're all connected, but anyway, he's visiting one of the Wallflowers' estate where they're all having Christmas together. Rafe is making it a goal. He's from America and he knows nothing about British society. And so he's having like all of his friends that are in the Wallflower couples, like, help him learn all that stuff so he can marry this woman he's betrothed to. However, he ends up falling for Natalie, that woman's cousin, instead. So it's very forbidden because he's not supposed to be falling for her cousin, obviously. This is such a fun read. Definitely good for the Christmas season if you want to read a Christmas romance really soon. But I would recommend you read the Wallflower series before this one. Anyway, so you have it. Those are some forbidden romance recommendations for you. Please let me know down below if you've read any of these books or if you plan to. And if you don't feel like commenting any of those things, you can leave me the shh emoji in the comment section down below. This is a forbidden romance. Anyways, thank y'all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye y'all. Wake up, today's gonna be a good day. 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 Wake up, today's gonna be a good day.